How do you optimize the production lines in a factory? You can't just assign jobs randomly to assembly lines. Every job has a deadline. Your goal is to reduce the overall make span to increase productivity. But setup costs and changeover costs incur downtime, and the energy and waste costs differ from machine to machine. Let's take a look at food packaging. Every time a manufacturing line switches the food type, the entire line must be cleaned. Let me show you how to minimize that downtime. Here I'm running the food packaging quick start from our Timefold quick starts repository. You can run this on your machine yourself if you want to. What you have here is we have a number of assembly lines, 5 of them, and we have 100 unassigned jobs. For example, a job to package broccoli and pumpkin in a large bag for a particular customer. And this needs to be done by the 6th of September at 4 o'clock. Ideally, however, it's done by the 4th of September already, just to have some buffer in case something goes wrong or the plan doesn't actually execute as it was intended. The entire job takes 2 hours and 51 minutes. And regardless of the assembly line, we could actually make it dependent on the assembly line. Some assembly lines might actually be faster, but this is not the case in this setup. And we need to assign, of course, which assembly line will do this job, and also when, in which order they will do the jobs. So if you look at them per job, what you can actually see is that this particular broccoli and pumpkin large bag can be done immediately. The ready time is we can start it right now, but it should be done, like I said, before the 6th of September by 4 o'clock. And the ideal time was actually today on the 4th of September by 4 o'clock too. So let's start solving this. Let's start assigning each of these jobs to an assembly line. And I'm just going to stop it immediately without actually doing any real optimization. And let's take a look at what we have here. So it's saying at this line one, we want to start with the tomato and pepper packaging. And then we want to do some cleaning. And then we want to do the pumpkin and onion bag. Now, the cleaning has to happen, but sometimes the cleaning can be very short. For example, when you're switching, right, like here, from broccoli to peas and broccoli, then you don't really need to clean the broccoli everywhere because, you know, the next food item is including broccoli. But however, when you switch from peas and broccoli to pumpkin and carrots, as you can see, the cleaning time is quite large. It's more than an hour. So that's one of the things we will want to optimize. We want to reduce those cleaning time by choosing these things more carefully. Now, if that would be the case, we could probably just have one line that does broccoli all the time. The reason we can't do that is because of these order deadlines, of course, right? We got in an order, and I just scroll out a little bit. As you can see, is that, for example, this first one we were talking about needs to be done by the 6th of September and ideally by the 4th of September. So to take those into account, we sometimes have to switch much faster between food types than we would actually want to do in an ideal world. So now let's follow it a bit longer and let's see what happens with the other constraints. Because if we actually look at this, you'll see that some of these jobs still happen. There's about, you can see here in the medium score, that's actually the number of jobs that still happen in the ideal time, outside of the ideal time. So here we have, for example, 2 jobs, as you can see, that are happening outside of the ideal time. So that's the first thing we want to optimize. And the second thing we want to optimize is, if you scroll out, we want to optimize the total make span of everything. Right now, to do all of the work, we're all the way up until the 7th of September at around, I guess, what is this, 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock. Ideally, we want to get all of that work done faster. And how do we do this? Simply by reducing the cleaning times, right? So let's zoom in again, all right, and let's start solving. As Timefold is optimizing this, it will reduce the make span of the entire thing and also reduce the cleaning time of each of the jobs. So here we have the solution, and as you can see, the number of cleanings actually went down. So we have shorter cleanings, as you can see over here, and sometimes we don't have any cleanings at all because we just have the exact same job type twice in a row. Now, let's scroll out a little bit, all right, and you can see overall the number of cleanings actually went down. And more importantly, you also saw that instead of running into past noon on Thursday, we are actually now almost finished by Wednesday evening. So we actually did the same work in less time. And simply by optimizing it better. If you look at it from a job point of view, you will still see that all the jobs are still happening within their ideal time. All of them are actually now happening in within their ideal time. There's not a single time in single job that happens in the red zone. And of course, none of the jobs happens after the red zone, after the due date. So that's also a good thing. There's two ways to define what we want to optimize here. One way would be we want to reduce the cleaning time. And I've actually tried that out and it didn't give me the best results. The reason for that is, yes, it reduced the cleaning time, but some of the assembly lines would take all the way into Friday to finish their jobs, while others would be done by Tuesday. So what I've done instead is I've actually asked it to reduce the overall make span of the entire schedule and to load balance it. So what does load balancing mean? Load balancing means that all of the assembly lines all have about the same ending time, right? So that, and we load balance it and then we push it to the left. So we basically try to take the, we look at the assembly line which has the longest time to finish all of its jobs, and we want to push that first to the left, then the second longest, then the third longest, then the fourth longest, then the fifth longest. So if you look at the code behind this, you'll see that that's actually the rule we implement, the constraint we implement, and that makes the whole thing work better. If you want to optimize your production lines, take a look at our open source quick start and come talk to us.